Student Congress on January 9, 2013 is called to order at 3:01 p.m. The Student Superintendent Council is a representative group of students from all 25 schools that meet once a month at the Ben Furlong Education Center, located at 8700 South Kyrene Road, Tempe. We regularly meet on our first Wednesday for each month from 2 to 4 p.m. We welcome interested staff and community members to attend our meetings to learn about the work of the SSAC. The SSAC Congressional Panel meetings are held in the public to consider topics of interest and simulate the work of the legislation by voting to propose on the legislation. This meeting will be filmed and will be available for viewing to interested students, parents, and staff members. A student will be sent about how to access the meeting from the district website. This year, we have organized ourselves into the Kyrene Student Congress, consisting of the House of Representatives, the Senate, and the Executive Branch. We have reviewed how the process of government works and will depend our knowledge through simulations. The 25 schools in the district are grouped into six regions. Each regional group has chosen a topic to research, present, and propose legislation for the Kyrene Student Congress. Our superintendent, Dr. Schauer, student representatives from SSAC, guests from the district office, and others will be here with us this afternoon. The regional panel sitting with me today consists of senators, representatives, the vice president, and president. We will now introduce ourselves to you. My name is Ariana Broom, and I am in fifth grade and attend Kyrene Del Norte School. During this session, I am serving as the president of the KMS region.
My name is AJ Gray, and I am in grade 5 and attend Kyrene de los Niños Elementary School. During this session, I am serving as the vice president of the KMS region.
My name is Daniel Bish, and I am in 8th grade and attend Apprende Middle School. During this session, I am serving as a senator from the KMS region.
My name is Madison, and I am in 5th grade and attend Kyrene de los Lomas. During this session, I am serving as the senator from the KMS region.
My name is Kate, and I am in grade 5 and attend Wagner School. During this session, I'm serving as a representative from the KMS region. Please stand for a moment of silence. Please face the flag and recite the Pledge of Allegiance with me.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Will members please state their names for the record? Let the record show that senators, representatives, the vice president, and president are present for this session. Let the record also show that members of the Senate and members of the House are present today. President?
What you were going to do is a roll call, so each person just says their name so that you know that they're present. Okay. So go ahead and start on the end and work this way.
Kate Alperin.
Madison Rowley.
Daniel Bish.
AJ Gray.
Ariana Broom.
And then you can go on to the agenda part.
May I have a motion to approve today's agenda? Second? All in favor signify by saying A. Opposed, nay.
Aye.
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 This afternoon, we will be hearing a presentation from the Pueblo region about the topic of increasing the availability of learning supplies for students. After questions and discussion, the House and the Senate will consider the recommended legislation pertaining on this topic.
It is my pleasure to introduce
just say the presenters from the Pueblo region. So it's my pleasure to introduce the presenters from the Pueblo region.
Okay. It is my pleasure to present the representatives of the KMS region.
And then the presenters can come forward to the podium. So you might want to go ahead and introduce yourselves to the panel so they know who you are to start with.
My name is Jasmine Collins and I'm from the Pueblo region.
I am Jacob Flores and I'm from the Pueblo region.
My name is Olympia Matik and I'm from the Pueblo region.
My name is Alex Manning and I'm from the Pueblo region.
My name is Jack Richards and I'm from the Pueblo region.
And you can go, go ahead. So we're gonna go ahead and do the presentation now. So it's time for the group to go ahead and do that. And feel free to move that microphone. It's very flexible, so you're all different heights. So keep moving it every time you need to.
Keeping our supplies in stock, Pueblo region. Jasmine, Jacob, Olympia, Jack, and Alex.
Why there aren't enough supplies? One answer might be that prices are too high. Another is there might not be enough supplies to go to each school. Or schools think it's fine to reuse worn out crayons and books, and so on. Eventually everything wears out and we need to buy new things. Or less budget from the state could be a solution.
What needs to be replaced is books, textbooks, desks, pencils and erasers, library books, paper, toilet paper, whiteboards, and school equipment.
That's a chart of all the prices for everything, and you can see that because we buy from the school district, everything is discounted. So we may not have to spend as much as you would think.
How will we pay? Some ideas are fundraisers like box top and fresh and easy donations. Another is a spring carnival. Children 5 and under will be free. Kids of 6 and up will be $2, and adults could be $5. Enrollment gives $25.75 per student, and recruit students to increase enrollment.
What we could do is try to get donations from different companies. We could require each school to put on a certain number of fundraisers per year. We could organize district-wide fundraisers instead of just for the schools. We could reduce wasted supplies and excess spending. And we could control how much stuff is used so we aren't wasteful. And we could try to increase enrollment.
Do members of this congressional panel have any comments or questions?
You talked about increasing enrollment and how the current school district gets $25.75 per each student. But for every student that the Kyrene School District adds, that's another textbook needed. That's another set of supplies, another set of resources needed to be used for that student. So does the $25 come, does it cover everything that would be needed, or would it have to be more controlled spending from the district?
The more students we get, the more money we get, and we do have some extra supplies, like we're not totally out of textbooks, so some of it would be paid for, and probably a lot more students would churn out more money.
But looking around where the textbooks are, the textbook that we currently have, the ones aren't being used are the ones in the worst condition. Ripped pages, hardly legible, the ones that aren't ripped are hardly legible, written all over, destroyed mainly. So that's something else that would need to be replaced with the money that is limited in this sense.
Yeah, I guess, but we do have quite a few extras in some of these things, not all. But we usually run out of pencils and paper, and pencils and paper are so cheap that $25.75 you can see for the price list would cover more than one student.
So are we proposing for more of the expensive supplies, as in laptops or textbooks, or more towards the more necessity supplies such as pencils, paper, more the everyday things?
Whatever's needed.
I had a question. How, on the spring carnival, like how do you think maybe we're gonna have to pay for how to get like all the like games and stuff?
Really, our student council actually earns really good money, so probably all the money that, or some of the student council makes, can actually spend on the spring carnival.
Okay.
We try to do a carnival at our school, but when you try and do those things, you can't, like, bring in games and like rides to the school. So how would we do that?
We don't actually mean roller coasters or actually carnival, like as you see in actual carnivals. We kind of mean in fall festivals, kind of like slides, and such as we do in our schools, we have slides that kids can play on. And actually, we bounce houses that actually are useful, not instead of roller coasters, because that would actually take money and we won't be allowed to do it.
Any further questions or comments?
The 7.0 section is for members to the public to share their thoughts with the congressional panel. If you wish to speak to the congressional panel, please fill out one of the blue cards located on the table by the door and bring it to our vice president. Mr. Vice President, are there any requests to speak to congressional panel?
I have one right here. This one asks, are there other groups at school that can help fundraise?
Maybe the student council or maybe the SSAC.
Thank you. Thank you. The second one asks, are textbooks paid in a different way fund than pencils?
We really don't know, but if they are, then we should pay the same way as textbooks are. If the pencils are paid the same way as schools or the district pays for it, then we should.
Thank you. The last one asks, would it be better to seek donations for paper, pencils, etc., or textbooks?
Well, really, if we could use donations for pencils and textbooks and ECT, if we can contact other schools and say if they have extra supplies that we could use for other schools, then maybe we could actually do donations for textbooks and pencils.
What do you guys define as excessive spending that is not needed? What objects do you find?
There's some stuff that we just don't need. Like more playground equipment. When you're out of paper and pencils, you really don't need playground equipment more. If you already have a bunch of stuff, you don't need to stockpile it.
As in?
If you have a bunch of paper already, you don't need to buy just to save if you're required to buy. In certain things, some computers and stuff don't need to be replaced every year, and there are certain things that we could just do without.
And then you also talk about controlling usage. Have you seen how the money in the Kyrene School District is spent, aside from a student perspective, more from a adult, seeing the bill and seeing where it is being used?
That comment was meant as not wasting the stuff that we have, not wasting paper, not wasting pencils, not wasting, I've seen kids breaking dry erase markers. We don't need to do that. If there was some sort of system we could create to prevent that, that would save quite a bit of money.
So we're talking more about controlling the materials within the school as well, and so that they're used to their full extent rather than pencils being broken just because the students have nothing else to do,
yeah,
rather than the spending of how it is being used.
Controlling how they're used.
The Kyrene Student Congress has been asked to consider the bill from the regional team that's presented today. The specific bill is increasing the availability for learning supplies for students. The first vote will be taken in the House of Representatives. I will ask for those in favor of the bill and count the raised hands. Next, I will ask for those opposed to the bill and count the raised hands. After tabulating the results, I will announce whether or not the bill passed or failed in the House.
So those of you that are House members can vote, not senators, just House members, including members of this panel. And so you can go ahead and ask them to vote now.
The second vote will be taken in the Senate. I will ask for those in favor of the bill and count.
Here we need to wait and take this first vote. Okay, then we'll do the second vote. Okay, so go ahead and do the vote for the House.
Those in favor, raise your hands.
Do you want to say once again what they're voting on so they know? You're voting on whether or not you agree with increasing the amount of school supplies available for learning for students. So if you're in favor of that, you should raise your hand.
Those not in favor, please raise your hands. In the House of Representatives, the bill passes.
The second vote will be taken in the Senate. I will ask for those in favor of the bill and count the raised hands. Next, I will ask for those opposed to the bill and count the raised hands. After tabulating the results, I will announce whether or not the bill passed or failed in the Senate. Sorry, in the House.
Really? Because it says House.
Okay. Those in favor of the bill, please raise your hand. Once again, we are voting if we should increase the amount of supplies for learning in the district. Those in the Senate that favor the bill, raise your hand. Those opposed to the bill, raise your hand. The bill has passed in the Senate and House. The president will sign the bill.
The bill has passed in the Senate and House. I plan to sign the bill. Next session on February 6, 2013 is the Altadena and Apprende Congressional Panel. The next presentation will be from Centennial, and their topic is increased time for special area classes. Each panelist responds to what did you like about being a member of the congressional panel today. Can I have our representative?
I thought it was an interesting new experience.
I thought it was fun to learn how your guys' thoughts were.
I enjoyed the ability to openly argue, if that be the right word, with you guys on your proposed bill.
I thought it was a very interesting and enjoyable experience.
I thought it was very fun to hear the Pueblo region's ideas about why we should increase school supplies. May I have a motion of adjourn? Second, all in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Aye. All opposed, say no. Motion of adjourn passes.
Thank you very much. Good job, everybody.